This is not financial advice, not legal advice, for entertainment, educational purposes only. Anything I say is my opinion. Please don't make any financial decision based on anything I say in these videos. That being said, hit the like button, subscribe button, all that YouTube algorithm stuff, so you get the videos I put them out. See them thinking, see them analyzing that data, but like I tell every day, the day they release us is false. Man, they give us a false narrative of the market so we can make bad trading decisions. Listen, I've told y'all in previous videos that I do QQQ and spy, put credit spread, call credit spreads, that I've been doing them all the time. And I tell you, and I've told you that I choose spy and QQQ because I feel those ETFs are very hard for the bad actors to manipulate, because there's just too many companies in QQQ. There's just too many companies in SPY that they can't really target it directly. And the reason I'm bringing it up today is I'm going 4 weeks. Listen to me. I'm going 4 weeks without a loss on QQQ, put credit spread, or call credit spreads. And I was talking to my buddy about it. He was like, you haven't lost in 4 weeks? Yo, I haven't taken a loss in 4 weeks doing QQQ put credit spreads and QQQ call credit spreads. And it is, what I do is not difficult. It's not easy. And I'm not telling you to do them. That's not what I'm telling you. I am not telling you to do them. That is not what I'm telling you. I'm just telling you that I personally have not lost on a QQQ put credit spread or call credit spread in 4 weeks. And even I was surprised by that. And this is all I do. And once again, I'm not telling you to do this. This is what I do. I look at the MACD, the RSI, and the 1348 EMA crossover above the 200 EMA line. That's all I do. I look at it. If it's telling me, oh, and then, you know, I look at the 5-minute chart, the 15-minute chart, I just see where it's going. But what I do is I use the 1348 crossover, and it tells me what direction, not guaranteed, but what direction I think the market is going to go in. And then what I do, if it says it's going to go up, then I buy put credit spreads, and I do them maybe $4 or $5 out. If they say it's going down, I buy call credit spreads $4 or $5 out. And then what I do is I buy them 3 days out. Well, 3 days out expiration. Like if it's Monday, the expiration is going to be Thursday. If it's Tuesday, the expiration is going to be Friday. If it's Wednesday, the expiration is going to be Monday, and so on and so forth. I do them 3 days out. And sometimes I've even closed them out the same day. I've closed them out the same day that I bought them because they've shot up in the direction that I wanted. Or sometimes I close them out the next day. And sometimes they go against me, but eventually they come back to where I thought they would be. So, and once again, I'm not telling you to do put credit spreads or call credit spreads on QQQ. That's not what I'm telling you. I'm telling you that I've been consistently making money while waiting for this AMC play using QQQ credit spreads. Anyway, please, some comments. Tell me what you think. Do you think the 1348 crossover is a great indicator? And do you think QQQ and SPY are great for credit spreads because they can't manipulate it as much? Anyway, have a great day. God bless, and I appreciate y'all on this journey with me.